Hello there everyone, this is Lydia from Altenew, and today I'm going to be sharing with you how to layer up the very beautiful Build-A-Flower Stargazer. So this one creates a beautiful lily with two layered leaves. So I'm going to start with the base layer of the beautiful lily that we have here, and I'm going to be using the pink diamond ink to do the base layer. So I'm going to use the colors that are on the back of the layering guide. Do refer to this when layering your images. So I'm just going to stamp this into place onto some white cardstock. Once I've done that, I'm then going to move on to the second layer. Now what I'm going to do is I'm going to add this on top, and I'm going to see where these line up. And as you can see, most of the endpoints of these petals do line up perfectly with the previously stamped layer. So I'm going to ink this one up using the Pinkalicious ink. I'm just going to ink that up and then pop it back into place. As you can see, the tips of those petals each have a darker point to them, so this one's really easy to pop into place and stamp perfectly. Next up, I'm then going to move on to the third layer. Again, I'm just going to pop this into place without it being inked up. And again, we do have these endpoints on each of the petals. I'm also going to make sure that I don't stamp those images in the center, because the stamen will be going on those later on. For this layer, I'm using the Rubellite ink, so I'm going to ink that up and pop that back into place. You can see just on the tips of those petals that they do layer up very, very well. So once I have stamped that, I'm then going to move on to the fourth layer. Now these are like little dots that give a lot of detail to the flower. Now these are going to go into the base of the petals, and I'm going to make sure that I don't stamp over those little stamen areas again. Again, I'm going to be using the Ruby Red ink for this, so I'm just going to make sure that they're within the petals but not over those little stamen bits that we have going on. I'm then going to move on to the stamens. Now these are going to fit into those little white spaces that we have going on, and I'm going to be using the beautiful Autumn Blaze ink for this. I'm going to add those into place, and then we have the little stamen stems, which I'm going to call them, and I'm going to use some frayed leaf to ink these up. So I'm going to pop them into place. The white space is there, so it's really easy to do. I'm then going to move on to the leaves. So we have two leaves in this set. This is the larger of the two. And for the base layer of this one, I'm going to be using the frayed leaf ink. I'm then going to take the second layer. Now the tips of the leaf do match up perfectly, so I'm going to go with this one with the Forest Glades. So I'm going to stamp that one into place. I then have the third layer of the leaf, and this is going to go onto the second layer. So it's going to go in the center of the second layer, and it's really easy just to pop into place. Don't worry if you go a little bit off with this one. I do find that leaves are easier to line up than the flowers. I'm then going to move on to the second leaf. So this is the smaller of the two. Again, I'm going to use the same colors as before. So for the base, I'm using the frayed leaf. The second layer of this leaf matches up perfectly along that right hand line, so I'm going to go with that one, and I'm going to ink this up using the Forest Glades. Again, this is the third layer, and it's going to fit in perfectly with that second layer that we've just stamped, and I'm going to be using Evergreen for this one. And that is how you layer up all of the images in the Build-A-Flower Stargazer stamp set.